such a large and splendid engine, one does have to keep up appearances, so.
Hello, Fat Face!
What a cheat! That Henry is getting too big for his wheels. Fancy speaking to me like that. Me! Me, who has never had an accident.
Percy was a bit puzzled. Oh, but Gordon, aren't jammed whistles and burnt safety valves accidents?
No, indeed. High spirits might happen to any engine. But to come off the rails like Henry did when he was pulling the flying kipper, well, I ask you, is it right? Is it decent?
A few days later, it was Henry's turn to take the express. Gordon watched him getting ready.
Be careful, Henry. You're not pulling the flying kipper now. Mind you keep on the rails today.
Fat face!
And Henry went on his way. But Gordon didn't care. He yawned and went off to sleep. But he didn't sleep long.
Come on. Wake up, Gordon. A special train's coming and we're to pull it.
Is it coaches or trucks?
It's trucks.
Trucks?
They lit Gordon's fire and oiled him, ready for the run. The fire was sulky and wouldn't burn, but they couldn't wait, so Edward pushed him onto the turntable to get him facing the right way. Gordon grumbled like anything.
I won't go.
Don't be silly. Gordon tried hard, but he couldn't stop himself being moved. At last, he was on the turntable. Edward was uncoupled and backed away, and Gordon's driver and fireman jumped down to turn him round. The movement had shaken Gordon's fire. It was now burning nicely and making steam. But Gordon was cross and didn't care what he did. He waited till the table was halfway round, but he couldn't stop it.
Get me out!
No, not a hope. You silly great engine. Don't you understand that? Don't you understand that,
They telephoned the Fat Controller.
So, Gordon didn't want to take the special train of trucks and ran into a ditch. What's that you say? The special's waiting? Well, tell Edward to take it, please. And Gordon? Oh, leave him where he is. We haven't time to bother with him now.
On the other side of the ditch, some little boys shouted out.
Cool. Don't they look silly? They'll never get him out.
And they began to sing.
Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch, fell in a ditch. Silly old Gordon fell in a ditch, so on a Monday morning.
Then the school bell rang, and they chased off down the road. Gordon was in a mess.
Oh dear, I shall never get out.
And he blew away three tadpoles and an inquisitive newt. And Gordon lay in the ditch all day long. And he was very, very unhappy. But that evening, they brought floodlights. Then, with powerful jacks, they lifted Gordon and made a road of sleepers under his wheels to keep him from the mud. Strong wire ropes were fastened to his back, and James and Henry, pulling hard, at last managed to bring him